Welcome to session 4 of lesson From Here to There. In this session we shall learn about the wheels of the vehicles, the fuel on which they run, and also the noise pollution created by vehicles. Names of some vehicles are given in the center of a wheel. Join these to the number of wheels each vehicle has provided at the left hand side of the wheel.
Bus has 2 wheels in the front and 4 wheels at the back. Hence they have more than 4 wheels. Bullock cart has only 2 wheels. A push cart has 4 wheels. Scooter has only 2 wheels. Rickshaw has 3 wheels. Car has 4 wheels. Metro rail has several wheels. Train also has several wheels. Boat has no wheels. Truck like bus has more than 4 wheels. Bicycle has only 2 wheels. Motorcycle also has 2 wheels.
Excellent. Based on the size and weight of the vehicles, number of wheels required varies. Now let's look at the right hand side of the wheel. Identify what runs the vehicle. You need to identify the energy source which gives the force required to pull the vehicle forward.
Buses is usually run either through petrol or diesel. Bullock cart is driven by pair of bullocks. A push cart is pushed by a human. Scooter runs on petrol. Rickshaw is pedaled by a human. Car runs on petrol. There are electric cars as well. Metro rail runs on electricity. Train also runs on electricity. Sometimes it uses diesel. Boat is rowed by a human. Truck runs on diesel. Bicycle is driven by a human. Motorcycle runs on petrol.
Well done. It is important to understand all vehicles need an energy source. Clean energy source like electricity that does not produce smoke is better for the environment. Find out from your elders, how did people travel 50 years ago? Were the present means of travel available at that time also?
My grandmother said, bullock carts, horses, cycle, steam engine trains, buses, and row boats were the main transportation that was available in olden days. Motorcycle, cars and other vehicles were not readily accessible.
Excellent. Can you imagine which vehicles people will use for travel 20 years from now? Ask your family members and friends.
My father said electric cars, electric buses and bullet trains are going to become common. A new solar-powered airplane is already being tested. We may also have rockets taking us to outer space.
Yes, as we burn more fuel, petrol and diesel will become more scarce. We will have to depend on electric and solar power. If anybody makes a chuk-chuk sound, you know at once that it is being made for a train. From the sounds given below, can you tell which vehicle it is?
Popor is auto rickshaw. Ghar-ghar is for motorcycle. Peen-peen is for van. Tup-tup is for horse cart. Tring-tring is for cycle.
These are the sounds of single vehicles. How does it sound when many vehicles run together on the road making different noises? Isn't there a lot of noise?
Yes, when all the vehicles come on the road, it becomes very noisy.
Where have you heard the maximum noise?
Every day at 9 o'clock when I go to school, my school bus stops at a junction. There is total traffic jam and lot of noise with so many cars, buses and autos.
Do you like so much noise? Why?
No, I don't like such noise. I feel tired after I spend time in the traffic jam. I like to play with my friends in a calm environment.
Yes, both sound pollution and air pollution caused by vehicles is not good for health and environment. We must try and reduce it as much as possible. With that, we have come to the end of session 4.